pretty sure she can hear me too. I'm fucked.
You are fucked. Well, girls so know when you watch porn, no matter what happens. They always know.
Yeah, they're a little sick.
They're watching it too.
Yeah. Well, welcome everybody to HutchCast Live, episode 20.
Sweet I'm your Jesus.
Host. I'm your host, Zach Hutchins, aka the Gaming Hutch. Joining me this week is the Ayatollah of the controller, Mr. Jace Baldridge.
Maybe.
And depressing dog himself, Tim Hayes. I need to think of a better name for you. If you don't want it to be depressing dog anymore, then we need to think of a better one.
I don't think he ever liked it.
I don't think he did either, but I
don't mind
it.
I don't mind.
I like it, though.
It's cool.
See, you guys just said that I was the low energy one, and now both of y'all are like,
you're doing a goddamn entrance! Tro.
Yeah, and you threw me off, because I'm talking about...
Farts.
We're talking about porn, and they just
and keyboards
like
keyboards and
yep, now we're starting.
But that was the perfect way to start it. You admitting the fact that you need to hide porn.
I'm talking about a keyboard. Come on. Oh, it's nice to see that he's perking up now, Jace.
Mm-hmm.
This is great.
It's about time.
Grumpy Gus
all day.
I know,
Grumpy
right? Gus. Well, we have a lot of awesome things we get to talk about today. It's halfway through the year, so we better do a mid-year review.
Yeah!
Video games, movies, anything we really want to talk about that's happened in the beginning of the year, that was fun. And kind of give 2016 a... Everybody knows that this year sucked when it's come to, you know, deaths, like celebrity deaths have
every
been out
year
of control.
Every year sucks with deaths.
Yeah, that's true.
It's just prominent people from when we were young that we've known of forever have been dying, and that's why it seems worse than usual.
You guys are bringing it down again.
Shut up, Twitter. People die every day.
Yep. Well.
Shut up.
Yeah, that's happy-go-lucky stuff there.
Zach over there reading the obituaries every day, like old person in the nursing home.
I do.
Seeing who he knows.
I look for that stuff. No, it's not very hard to find. You go on Twitter whenever something happens, and it's immediately like hashtag prayers and thoughts or thoughts and prayers. You know,
that's always even if it's like if there's just a single name on like the trending list. Especially if they're like over the age of 50, I'm like, oh no,
they're dead.
I'm like, oh no, they're not dead yet. Okay,
right.
I don't
care. Well, we're gonna do that. We also are gonna. We have the first time that somebody has requested a topic on the show.
Ooh.
So my sister Tim's girlfriend has a topic that
what
she wanted
she
to bring
up.
So we're gonna talk about that in relation to you.
Yeah.
Your viewer and fan. She watches the show.
No, she specifically told me she doesn't like Jace on the show. So.
Oh, okay.
I don't blame her.
You're enemy.
Oh, my enemy.
You're my enemy. So we're going to get, I'm going to bring up a question for you guys later, and I think it's a fun one, and especially when it pertains to Twitch and streaming. So that'll be a nice little question. And then Tim is going to give us an update on all of the shit that we gave him to play. We gave him a laundry list of games to play, and he's going to update us on that.
Woo!
But we might as well start off by looking back and recapping 2016. I'm going to kind of... Jace, you have a list of everything that's come out? Because I do have a pretty extensive list here, too.
I went ahead and, just like I did in March, I think we did it at the 1st of April. The first quarter, I went on Metacritic and I pulled up, you know, the like 50 top rated games that came out in the first 3 months. I went through it and I kind of just, let's see, I have about 14, I wrote about 14, like the most notable ones in my head. And if you guys had any more to put in beyond these. And going through it, I know we were pretty down on the first quarter.
Yeah.
I think I had the most games that I was interested in the first like quarter, and it was only like five.
Right.
Something like that, right?
Yeah, it was really slow beginning.
It was very slow. I mean, and I don't even know about most notables, which is normal, even though March usually has some nice ones. Second quarter, I don't usually associate. I'm like, okay, maybe April or May might have, you know, one or two.
Right.
Like I said,
not this year.
I put about 16 games here between April 1st or so and now. Yeah. Like I said, some of them I have played. Some of them I've beaten. Some of them are more notable ones that I'm interested in, and then other ones are just like higher, like not higher level, but ones more desirable ones. I don't know how to put
sure.
it. But these ones, I just went through and I took 16 out. Well, technically, I guess there's 14. I took 13 out of the top 50, and then I had to go way down on Metacritic to get the 14th one.
Oh, wow.
Which is bullshit.
That's crazy.
I just
have a list of games that have come out, and I'll be just maybe incorporating some of them. So.
All right. We'll just go the highest rated game via Metacritic that came out during the quarter is Uncharted 4.
Yeah. Ah.
We all played, yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, we talked about it quite extensively. Love, yeah. So,
you know, even that right there, huge game that came out in the quarter.
Mm-hmm.
So that's already a big old plus.
I mean, that's one that we've been waiting years for. So mm-hmm. that's kind of one of those games that it could have a month to itself and it would be a good month.
Yeah.
And that's not the only thing in that month, so that's incredible.
Like, I was going to, because one of the reasons I wanted to do this topic, besides, you know, just staying, you know, keeping stuff fresh in our heads, was I wanted to keep a running top 10 of the year and, like, you know, input as stuff came out. And I did not, we were too busy playing Overwatch today.
Yeah.
And I did not make this list.
It did it. We're too busy getting our asses handed to us.
Oh my god, we should
Overwatch today.
Yeah, that hurt. I'm still sore.
But yeah, Uncharted would definitely break that top 10 for me.
What about The Witness, bro?
Witness is on there too.
All right, cool. Sorry, I'm jumping the gun.
No, you're fine. No, see, that's part of it, though, because The Witness was in my head when I was talking about, like, top 10, because The Witness was number one going into the second quarter.
Because that was still first quarter. I mean, like, I have everything pulled up for the first quarter also.
But yeah,
I think let's just kind of talk about second quarter stuff for now, because there's a lot
exactly,
to go through.
Exactly. Next on the list is the game we just mentioned, Overwatch, came out.
Boom.
Ah. And I know when it came, we were all kind of on the fence about it.
Yeah, multiplayer only.
Multiplayer only. $60, MOBA tendencies.
No, I wasn't.
Bullshit!
I wasn't thinking about that.
Bullshit. But we all ended up getting it.
Yeah,
and,
you're alone.
And now we're having fun playing it.
It's very fun with multiple peoples.
Yeah.
Even though, as we found out today, multiple people in a party kind of fucks you over.
Yeah, it really does, doesn't it?
When you lose to six people that are playing Soldier 76, something's wrong. Were you there for that one, Zach?
No.
They went. They all went 76. Steamrolled us.
And then the next match, they all went Torbjorns. Torbjorns. And they just sort of.
Destroyed
we could
us.
Not get close at
my
all.
God,
they destroyed us. It was.
They're trying Reinhardt,
miserable
combos.
That was only one of the, like, teams that we played that had all, like, high level stuff. It was rough.
I jumped in late, so I didn't see some of the garbage you guys sat through. We could have a whole show probably about Overwatch right now. So
it'd just be whining right now.
Yeah, we're definitely going to see more streams on the Gaming Hutch of coming from Overwatch when we're all party chatting.
Multi streams
because at Jace Plays Games we'll be playing in the same party as this channel right here, and that'll be
fun. Have you been streaming a lot recently?
I only streamed the first night that we played. But I'm going to be.
I remember that because
I came home and I was really drunk.
Drunk, and then trying to set it up like on the fly as you're joining the game that was already going on.
And then I got in and it was over. And I was like, "What the fuck? It's over! I just started." And
you jump in so late.
So yeah, I came home from a pool that night pretty tipsy already, and I probably shouldn't have played. What's hilarious is the first half of the stream, you can't hear the party chat because I had it hooked up wrong, and then I realized it was wrong, and then there's a whole match where I'm just moving around fixing it, but I didn't turn the stream off, like, so I'm just walking around, like, fixing it, and you guys are playing, and I got booted out of the game.
So that whole time, one, you're drunk when you got in. It's Zach's first time playing.
Yeah.
First time playing. He's drunk and he's trying to set up his thing. So who knows how long, like how much he's actually paying attention. And he's just going, what do I do? How do I do this? Why isn't this working? What are you doing? I don't even know where to go. I don't know what to do.
Damage.
What is going? I got a kill. Oh my God. I got a kill. And we're like, dude, calm down.
Well, then he picks the metro and he's like, am I doing damage? What's going on here?
I have no idea. So what's really bad, I don't really remember playing Zemetra because it only lasted a couple minutes. And then
no, that lasted a long time because you did not die for some reason. And you just kept dicking around. The rest of us getting our asses handed to us and here you are just putting up little things. Oh, man.
Oh, that was really fun. I've learned a lot since then and now I'm playing like a semi-competent idiot.
I won't be surprised if within the next week he's going to come back. Zach's going to come back, and he's going to be like, I have all these notes for all the different players, and these are where you use them. This is where you use them against. This is the defense. Use this team for this defense.
Yeah, that's...
He does research and shit.
I do. Counters. Like I did with Smite. That's totally what's starting it's already starting to happen with this game. I've already went. It's going to pertain to something I'm going to talk about later, so I don't want to talk a lot about it right now. But I have been watching some Overwatch to learn.
Huh? Oh, the streaming.
Yeah, I've been watching some streamers and watching some gameplay and tips and stuff in order to try to get better. So
tits.
Yeah. Oh, always watching. Tits. Always on the tits.
All right. Overwatch.
Yeah, Overwatch. Overwatch is, it's not even my favorite game to come out. It's not my favorite game to come out the second quarter, but it's probably the most fun. I still think I'm going to believe that's true even when we read off all the other games.
So your number one game is not the most fun?
I know. What? Who plays video games for fun?
No, it's
idiots.
No,
idiots, dummies.
I would give it to like Ratchet and Clank, which I had a lot of fun with, but I also it had a great story, so it kept me involved. And then the combat was fun, and it's so like it's not just a fun fact. All Overwatch is mechanics, so it's like is the game fun or not? And yes, it's a great time, but there's a better game out there, which is Ratchet and Clank, which came out because it has a story and it's. Like, it's a single-player thing, so it is more my style, even though I'm having fun with Overwatch. So I would say that Ratchet & Clank is my favorite game to come out second quarter, but I'm having the most fun, like, overall. Like, I'm having a great time with Overwatch. It's probably the most fun because I'm playing with my friends or whatever, but Ratchet & Clank was a better game.
Spoilers. Here's another one.
Does that
one
make
that
sense? Okay.
No.
We'll have to come back to that. I think we could spend a lot of time on
as, that. As Zachary mentioned, Ratchet & Clank also came out. It's not the next one on the list, but was mentioned already. Ratchet & Clank came out this quarter.
I love that game.
I don't know much surprise to everyone, but it was definitely more well-received than I think most people thought it was going to.
Yeah,
shit.
I've not heard any negative about it. The most negative I've heard is I've played this in two different versions before. I don't need to play it a third, which is not a negative thing, really. That's why I said it's the most negative. I haven't played it yet. But I only hear...
Damn. Oh, my God. That's awesome.
Is that you, Jace?
Yeah
dude. We got sweet storms going on. That was loud.
That was really loud. If we lose Jace mid-show... Sorry, yeah.
It, like, went into my mic and into my earphones, so then I heard it and and I was just like, what?
That was cool.
Ratchet & Clank's definitely one that I'll be picking up once I find it, like, used for cheaper or Best Buy sells it for $20 or something.
It should already be cheap. It's $40 new.
I believe, as you found out the other night, for snacks, I eat cans of peaches.
No, that was a dinner.
That was
like, what are you having for dinner?
Jason's
like, I just opened a can of peaches.
I said, I'm going to go get a snack and I got a can of peaches. It was a snack.
I'm pretty sure that was like your sustenance like for the day.
It was like way late.
Anyway. But that's not fair because I'll eat like a can of pineapple just like for a snack because it's freaking awesome. Just tastes really good.
I kind of did eat one of our sponsors for lunch today.
That was your lunch? Your lunch was a bag of chips?
It was a mid-dinner lunch time because I didn't get out of bed until like noon something and I wasn't hungry yet. So I was like, I'll just wait till dinner. And to hold myself over, I ate what little bit of chips I had left.
And Zach, we're not going to talk about what you eat because you just like to hurt yourself. I don't know, Jason, were you on when he was like, the other night, I'm reheating Indian food. Oh, hold on. And then he left because he got diarrhea and had good shit.
I did not ever do that. I ate that Indian
like
food.
An hour later. And then today, he's just like stuffing his face full of Taco Bell. Fucking A, Zach. You're just like depressed and want to hurt yourself.
That Taco Bell was so good. It went down so nice.
Went down so nice.
I love Taco Bell, man. It is good stuff. And now I'm drinking Miller Genuine Draft, which is also
not a sponsor. Not a sponsor.
It's also very good on the gut.
Not a sponsor.
Oh, this show is awesome. I love this show.
The next one is, I believe Tim is the only one who has played this. Dark Souls 3.
Played some today. That game's amazing.
How far are you in it? Are you even close to done?
I don't know. The games, you could probably... I don't know, like, the specific path to beat the game, but then you could miss so much. There's, like, so much optional shit in there. I have no idea where I'm at.
Optional, like, what? Optional bosses?
Optional areas, optional boss fights. There's areas you don't need to go into to beat the game.
Okay.
So I'm just throwing it out there, like...
Yeah?
You're getting it, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, so today I was in this... Doing it. I was in this area, having a hard time, just getting my ass handed me. So I popped it. An ember, and then you can like summon someone to come help you out.
Mm-hmm.
Got a guy. What was his name?
Ricky
Sanchez, and he made his character look like Golem. It was crazy. He had like this stupid little loincloth, the skinniest guy with the biggest eyes. I'm like, oh, this guy, I have to summon him. So I summon him up, and he like kind of comes in, does a little fist pump, and then he whips out this gigantic two-handed club, and he's just like walking around. Killed everything. I just kind of like followed behind him, and he fucking carried me like through probably like a half hour's worth of the game. I was just like, "Holy shit, Ricky Sanchez!"
The old dirty Sanchez.
Oh man, it was great. Oh, I should have taken it.
That's fantastic.
That sounds like a gameplay moment you'll never forget. Holy
was the
shit!
Best.
That's incredible.
Yeah, the game's it's awesome. I like how you can. It's nice because you can summon people to help you out. And it's not just for boss fights. Like, they can kind of, like, help out in different areas. And then another cool thing about it, I know we don't have to talk too much about it because this isn't really what we're doing, but you can, like, join factions and then get summoned to other worlds or someone will summon you to, like, help other players out. So for whatever reason, I was, like, summoned to a world to, like, kill some guy because he came into an area where, like, my faction ruled. And so, like, it'll randomly summon someone from my faction in there to fight him. Whatever.
So as you're playing it, say you're walking around and you're like doing your thing, you just transport somewhere else without any warning?
Or does it
prompt up and say to accept to be transported or not?
No, it you can't accept or decline. It'll just prompt. It just says, I don't know.
You're being pulled out of your gameplay experience to go do something else.
Yes, but...
That's shit.
Yeah, that would piss me off, though.
Well, it's because you don't have to do that because you don't have to be part of a faction. It's like,
okay, so it's optional.
Yeah, it's completely.
So it's kind of like on Watch Dogs when you know the multiplayer aspect of that was people can come and invade your area.
Yeah.
You had like final, but you can turn that option off. So if you didn't want to deal with that nonsense, you could turn it on and off. So okay, not as bad.
You don't have to. You can turn it off to where you can't warp. Uh-huh. But you can't turn it off to where people can warp in your game because you can still get invaded.
Okay.
But I mean, like, that's just part of the game. You'll still be going. But the thing is, like, it'll take you out, and then once you're done, it puts you, like, back in the exact same spot. All the same enemies are still dead. It's not like you're starting over once you come back.
But what if you died when you went out there?
That's how you come back. You either kill the guy or die. I ended up dying this time because the... guy I was sent there to kill warped in another guy at this giant ass club and just fucking killed me. So was like, I don't know. It's a lot of fun.
Dark Souls 3. I knew you would have a lot to say about that.
Ricky Sanchez. That's incredible.
Ricky Sanchez. God,
it's like the best story, you feel.
It's a great game. All right, the next one on the list, Doom.
Doom.
Has anyone here played that?
I have not yet. I did not buy it when it was on sale.
I have it, but I haven't started it.
I haven't started it yet.
It was on sale?
It was not last week, but the week before. It was $40 at Best Buy.
By the way, it's on the Steam Summer Sale for $36. Right now, actually.
That sucks, because then you're playing on the PC.
Steam Summer Sale, by the way, going on right now.
And PlayStation Flash Sale, too.
Get your favorite PC games from anywhere between 10% to 80% off. Maybe even
higher. It's like I'm on an airplane.
PlayStation Flash Sale happening at the moment. Up to 80% off on any...
PlayStation Flash Sale.
I bought the Borderlands, Telltale Borderlands game, Tales from the Borderlands, for $4 or $4.50 on the Flash Sale.
Didn't you buy that Borderlands like Telltale pack back in the day?
No. Okay. I had bought all of the games individually already. Because I had already owned everything up to that point, and then they released it, and it's like comes with all these other things.
Hey, Queen, real quick, just shout out to, is anyone else excited for the Telltale Batman game?
Very excited, yes.
Thank you, Zach.
I'm so pumped for Telltale Batman.
Jace is waiting for the Telltale Green Lantern game. Sorry, Jace.
And every option is, do you want to turn into a lamp or a shoe?
A chair.
Or a shoe.
I don't know how Green Lantern works. So, that's five big games that came out, right?
Those are huge, yeah.
Pretty huge games,
Just for quarter two?
Just for quarter two. The rest of them are kind of, they're lower. Some of them are mobile, PC. Although there's another one on here, we'll just keep going down it. Another one I picked off just because it's an interest of the show was Final Fantasy IX on the PC.
Yeah, that's a huge deal.
Big deal.
Because that'll probably be the version that will end up getting on PlayStation 4. Essentially, and that same version, but with trophy support.
I thought it was out on PS4. Is that not true?
Nine? No.
You haven't ported it over yet.
No, you can download the PlayStation Classic on your PS3 or your PS Vita console, but you cannot get it on PS4.
Cool. I was thinking of the Final Fantasy VII port you guys were telling me about last
year. Yeah, so Final Fantasy VII port is the one you should definitely get. Not 9. I would lose my shit if they released the 9. I would go to platinum that game in a second, too. I would actually go and fight that big spherical super boss and kill him. I'll finally kill him if they re-release this game.
I still need to get past Kuja. I've never done it. Like the second one where he's got like the double trance or whatever the fuck. Mm-hmm. Or no, he goes into trance.
Yeah, and he's like red and he just...
It's like attack, attack, attack. And then I finally get one attack in there. I'm like, attack. And then he comes back, attack, attack, attack.
Final Fantasy X and X-2 HD made their ways onto PC as well.
Yeah.
Did you guys ever play X-2? X-2.
I played it. I didn't beat it because I got to the end and I saw my percentage wasn't going to get to 100 and I got mad and I quit.
You can do a 100% run in one playthrough to play pain in the ass.
I have the books.
Yeah. I have 100% in that game. I saw the secret ending. And
Dragon Brothers.
Okay, get to 100%, you get a secret ending. Spoilers. That's what happens in most of those games, right? So I actually really liked Final Fantasy X-2. The story is not great, and it's kind of annoying. But the battle system, when you like get deep into that battle system, it's freaking awesome.
Like it's pretty
fun. The setting is kind of stupid, but the game is fun.
Yeah.
I agree.
It's a class like system. It's a class system that you get to change on the fly. Also, and it doesn't penalize you for changing classes. It actually rewards you for changing classes.
A thousand words.
Yeah.
Is a terrific song. A thousand words goes out through the ages.
I doing the dance moves.
Ah, so good. after this, this is a different one. Zach can go off a little bit more on this one. Severed is next.
Yeah, that game.
Yeah.
That game was somehow critically liked. I don't understand because it is a baby game.
Metacritic user rating is not bottomed out, but it's much lower than critical rating.
Yeah. Did you say Severed or Fruit Severed. Ninja? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, got it.
No, exactly. That's the problem. It is a fucking Fruit Ninja game that you have to just turn your panels. That game sucks. It sucks. And I heard the Platinum's really easy, but I just don't even want to go do it because you could, I guess, follow a guide and you can get the Platinum in like a couple hours.
Following a guide in today's day and age?
Yeah.
You said you had books for Final Fantasy X, too. I got the books.
So? I do. But that,
no,
like,
I'm talking about Jace.
I do have multiple books for 10 and 10, too.
But I mean, I use strategy guides, especially back in the day. Like, I loved strategy guides back in the day. But if I was playing, the only ones I have are Final Fantasy ones.
Even if I don't use them, I have them because they all look cool together.
Let's agree on the best strategy guide ever made, and that was for Pokemon Red and Blue.
That was a. Is it? No, yes. It's not well written enough. Like, it's too confusing.
It was great. I'll tell you why. Because back in the day, I didn't have internet when that came out, and it was just like showing us every Pokemon. That was my childhood right there. Boom. You guys don't agree?
The maps are bad.
I never used the book for it.
The maps are really bad.
I used the internet.
You had internet back then?
Or friends. Or when it first came out and I was playing it in fifth grade or whatever.
I mean, it came out in 1998. The internet was
Yeah.
Well, it was around, but fuck, I think.
No, it was not readily available to 5-year-olds.
Yeah.
Fifth graders.
5-year-olds.
Next. I don't know if you guys have played this one, but I own it, and I haven't played it yet. Enter the Gungeon.
I haven't played it. Hers good, though.
Yeah, I have too.
Good ratings. It sounds very interesting. It's like music-based and beat-based on how you move through dungeons to kill stuff.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Which is why I had no interest in it, because I don't have
like so, it's not a rhythm game, but there's the big emphasis on the music that's playing. If I understand correctly, unless I'm thinking of something else.
I may be thinking of something else.
You might be thinking of something else, because Enter the Gungeon looked like a rogue style.
Necromancer?
Oh, shit. You're thinking Crypt of the...
But yeah, I'm thinking of that one.
Crypt of the Necrodancer. You're thinking Crypt of the Necrodancer.
Enter the Gungeon
is the roguelike with the... all the crazy characters and crazy guns.
Okay. Either way, I hear good things, and you know, there's good ratings for it. It was fairly high on the list. So
yeah, it looks kind of like The Binding of Isaac.
Yeah, it's a procedural generated same idea as Binding of Isaac.
Yep.
I don't really like those games. So
I'm not a huge fan either. Although Rogue Legacy is. Phenomenal.
Rogue Legacy is, oh
god,
god
damn,
I cannot praise that game enough. Tim, I played that game with you, didn't I? A couple of years ago when we were in Iowa.
Really, a couple of years ago?
That was already 2 years ago.
Because I got it in August when it came out, and that was 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Time flies.
Mm-hmm. Yep. The next one is a 3DS title, Bravely Second.
Cool.
Either you... play the first Bravely Default.
I've never heard of that game.
It was a Final Fantasy when it started, and then they decided they wanted to... It wasn't like... They didn't feel like a Final Fantasy per se, so they changed the marketing of it and changed the name. Even though when you play it, you can feel there's Final Fantasy blood running right through it.
And it's supposedly really, really, really good. People who like Final Fantasy like this game better, way better than they've liked any Final Fantasy game that's
Correct.
Come out since like 10. Everybody said it's like the best Final Fantasy game since 10. Like,
and it's not even Final
it's not
Fantasy,
a Final Fantasy game.
What makes a Final Fantasy game a Final Fantasy game? Chocobos, Moogles,
being
classes,
good.
Turn-based battles.
Yeah,
basically what Final Fantasy
good characters, good stories, sort of class-based. Like there are class-ish stuff.
Yeah.
I think turn-based battles.
Like
too. Turn-based battles is something that mattered to me.
I played.
And that's
played
why. That's why 12 like lost me forever, and then 13 was garbage.
I played a little bit of the first Bravely Default, and but I had it on the cartridge. I liked what I played, but I ended up selling all of my DS cartridges and just decided to go digital on my handhelds, and I just haven't gotten it again because they will not lower the price on. Nintendo won't lower their prices, and I'm just like, I'm not paying $40 for that game, especially now when the second one has come out, and the first one is still $40.
If you were to go try to buy like Super Smash Brothers Brawl for Wii, it would still be like $50.
They're crazy.
Seriously, they don't ever lower the price ever on anything.
It's kind of like Blizzard games. Blizzard does the same thing.
The next one, I had another one on here, but I'm going to go ahead and skip it.
Yeah,
I had Grand Kingdom on here. It just came out. It's
getting a lot of people are saying it's
getting a lot of good reviews, but I looked at it and it is like tactile movements like Final Fantasy Tactics and stuff, and I just am not about that. It's tough for me. Although, like I said, if that is your type of thing, I'd say definitely give it a go. It looks cool and it sounds cool, but like
what platform
is that
for? 3DS?
It's on PS4. It just came out like Tuesday.
It's PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita.
That's right.
Maybe in a handheld. That's the only time I like those types of games.
I like some of those games. So like for me, it just depends. Like I love Final Fantasy Tactics. I love the old Shining Force games. But then some grid-based games like Fire Emblem and stuff I'd never have gotten into. I don't know why.
The next one, I think I'm the only one who played this, Alienation. That came out on PS4.
Yeah, that kind of just came and went, didn't it?
Well, nobody fucking got it.
Nobody played it.
When you get so far into it, it's hard to get further in when nobody on my friends list like got it. So it's really hard to get further into it. What I have played, I loved it. That game's fucking awesome. It's definitely in my top 10 for the year so far.
Not a lot of hype. Really? There was just no hype on it, and they didn't.
There was
no ads
no
for it. No nothing
outside of Colin Moriarty. There was really no hype for it outside. But yeah, it's fucking awesome. It's definitely once it inevitably goes on sale, it's got to be something people check out. It's fun. It's really really fun.
Well, let me know when it goes on sale and I'll get it and then we can play it.
I like House Smart Games, man. I like Dead Nation.
It's better than Dead Nation.
Well,
is it better than Shadow of the Beast?
It's better than Stardust. It's better than all those. This game is great. It may even be better than
Helldivers?
Rezogun spinning around. No, I think it's better than Helldivers, yes.
That almost doesn't surprise me. Helldivers is cool, but
I'm totally over Helldivers. I would rather play Magicka.
Oh, there you go.
If we were to play a game like that, I'd be Magicka.
Next one, Downwell. That just came out recently. Downwell, I don't know 100%. I just know it's one of the bigger name like indie titles that have come out. It's gotten a lot of good reviews and whatnot. I'm not even 100% what it is.
It's an auto-scroller where you're falling downwards and you have a gun and you're moving back and forth. It's like, so yeah, it's an auto-scroller where you're just going down.
Is it kind of arcadey?
Yeah, it's very, very, very arcadey. You try, you see how far you can go on one life, and then you start all the way over. It's a game it's a game to see how far you can go, and then it stops. It starts over.
Awesome.
It sounds like a mobile game.
I think it is a mobile game. Or is it on Vita?
Shit.
I'm not sure. I think it's on Vita. I'm pretty sure it's on Vita.
By mobile, I meant phone.
Mobile, I know.
It is on that, too.
But the last two that I'm going to mention on this here list are ones where I actually had to go down a little further into the Metacritic to find. And the first one is Star Fox. Finally came out to the the crowd. Like I said, there's parts in it where it feels like Nintendo 64 Star Fox, and you feel like, oh my God, this is what I want. Like, it's fun. It's a blast. And then it switches over, and it's like, now use your controller as a second screen where you have to use it to aim whilst turning and spinning and tilting all at the same time. Good luck. And it's just like, holy shit. I did play it. I did beat it. Like I said, I enjoyed most of it, but there are parts of it where I was just like, this is not what we wanted. It's, I don't know. I just, it doesn't look good for a Star Fox.
Very disappointing.
Doesn't sound good.
So I just want to say Downwell came out first on mobile devices last year in October.
Oh, did it?
And okay. It just now got ported to PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita.
Oh, wow. Okay. Mobile. And then, but I know I'm the only one who played Star Fox. And the next one is the latest of the just shit on games that apparently I like that nobody else does. Mighty No. 9 came out on Tuesday. Yeah. And people fucking hate it.
I don't see this game.
And I know why, but I don't understand the why.
Yeah. Break it down, Jace.
Mighty No. 9, if you like Mega Man at all, or old school side scrolling platforms where you're shooting enemies, there's something in it that you can enjoy. The game is there. The game is fun to play. Gameplay is good. There's a couple aspects to it that are questionable when it comes to the controls, but I'm not going to sit here and say Mega Man was without little glitches or weird things on controls every once in a while. Sure. This one has kind of the same aspects where I'm like trying to go to an edge and drop and hang on it, and he just sits there and won't do it. And then sometimes he'll do it and he'll just not fly off, like off of, you know, the map, but I'll go way further than I wanted to. And I feel like I did the same as if I wasn't going over the edge. But again, that's any of those like pixel perfect, like platforming, moving around games. The shooting and like building up your score and your multiplier by you injure the enemies to make them crit, and you can keep shooting them and to kill them, or you can hit R1 and you dash into them and it kills them, and it gives you depending on how fast you dash into them, you get a percentage. You're basically absorbing like their they're all like corrupted. All the robots are like corrupted, and so you're absorbing it, trying to like save everyone. And so you're absorbing it and you get points, and then there's like trophies and shit associated with points. And but the gameplay is fun. It's quick. Like I went back in today and I'm just trying to go in and like do the levels as fast as I can, and just the speed up, because I've mentioned part of the reason I like Mega Man is how fast can I beat it. Mm-hmm. Like, can I do it faster than I did before? Same thing, that's why I said with Destiny, there's Mega Man aspects to it. How fast can I beat these levels? With this one, it's the same thing. Like, I'm getting that, oh, if I do this, I can get past this part just a little bit quicker. If I know where they're going, I'm going to hit them, I'm going to go a little bit quicker. Like, that same little, like, addiction loop is there. Like, I'm dying, and some of the levels are very questionable in design. Like, it's supposed to be fast. The game is fast, quick. But there's two levels in particular where it's slow. Mm. One of them is a vertical one where there's a lot of, like, waiting and jumping and waiting and jumping. And then there's another one that's a side, like, the screen side scrolls. And so, you know, you're
held to... It's like an auto-scroll?
Yeah, so you're held only as fast as the screen will go. Which Mega Man had both of these types of levels, too. So it's not like it's unseen, unfounded. It's just those aren't the levels I like, but you know they fit in the game for the level and the boss that they are. The characters are pretty stupid. The story is pretty stupid. I'm not gonna say Mega Man had the greatest story of all time either, though. But as I've established on here, I've established on many conversations with many different people. If the gameplay is good and the gameplay is fun, I don't give a shit about the story. Like, the story, if it's great, awesome. It's bonus. If it's bad, I don't care because I'm having fun playing it. I can skip all the bad stuff, and I'm just playing the game. And I just feel like a lot of the negativity that it's getting is the story around it, how it was brought up, how it was advertised, how the expectations people set themselves to have for it. And they're just letting that carry them, and they're just not really acknowledging the game itself. I really didn't like it my first play session that Zach said he went back and watched on Twitch. And I think I just complained the whole first hour that I played it.
Yeah, well, and it didn't look fun either, though. Like, I was watching and I was like...
Yeah, because I was trying to do controls and I was like, this is... It's not intuitive. It doesn't feel right. It's weird. But then just even after I stopped that night... that session, I went back later that night and I really started, like, trying to play it. And I started grasping it and getting it. I got a couple more bosses done. I quit. I came back the next day, yesterday, and that's when it really was, like, clicking, and I went through, and I beat the second four bosses. I beat the castle, like, levels. I got stuck on the last boss, but I was like, I know exactly what I need to do. There's one aspect of it that I couldn't get past, but I finally figured it out. But that's Mega Man 2, is what bosses do I use to beat the other bosses, and what is their...
But I heard that's their, the problem with Mighty Number 9, though, is that, like, these boss moves that you get all suck. I heard that it's broken because there's one that breaks the game.
There is, like, one, and I found it, and it's fantastic. And, like, but,
so it's completely unbalanced, and it's...
Same thing. You can get through any game of Mega Man.
Mega Man 2 is the worst culprit.
Any of them. I'm just saying, you can get through it by just shooting your Buster. That's all you need.
That's true, but I'm saying, like, when the weapons in Mega Man are supposed to be very fun, they're supposed to be varied, but they're supposed to have specific effects on certain bosses, certain enemies that will...
And they all do it in this game too?
Yeah, but I heard that it's not executed well in Mighty Number 9. That's been a major complaint.
It's executed the exact same way as Mega Man.
Hmm.
And the people who say it otherwise are going in there with, I don't know what the reverse of rose-colored glasses are, but they're instantly going in wanting to hate it.
Well, you said it took you like over an hour to get into it.
That's because the first of it, the controls itself, but as far as what Zach's bringing up with killing robots, stealing their powers, and using those to get through, just like with Mega Man, if it's a new Mega Man game, you have to figure out which level is the first one you play. And that's the real big, like, tough thing to figure out. Because I finally found one, and I was able to beat it with my Buster, basically. And then I got his special weapon, and I kind of looked at the different guys, and I said, I think it's going to be strong against this one. And just like Colin said on P.S. I Love You, it gives it away if... You have the right weapon for the level, which is like, whatever. That's how they decided to do it. It's not Mega Man.
I was going to say, they actually tell you which ones are weak against what if you have it.
After you get the first one, yes.
Yeah, so once you figure out a boss that you can beat with just your regular gun, you then can always cherry pick your levels in order to have the strong gun.
Yeah, and that's why I go back to, I got that weapon. I went to the next level because I was doing it with being told, okay, it gives you a little extra advice to where you can, gives it away that it's the right level to go to next. But I sat there and was like, all right, just based on what the weapon is, I think it's this one. And I was right half the time. So the same Mega Man, like, mindset of how they set the old games up, where when you're going from one boss to the next, there's some kind of connection between the weapon that you're getting and the boss, and, like, his element or whatever his level is. The same thing is in this game. The exact same thing. I said, this is a ground-based attack that I'm getting. I'm not going to go for the sniper. That doesn't make sense. I'm not going to go for a guy who goes in the air. That doesn't make sense. I'll go against the guy with the sword. He has a blade. He's going to be grounded. I went to him and said, advice. I said, boom. I figured it out. Went to it, used the weapon, was able to dispose of him pretty easily. Because of the weapon. And I took his weapon to the next one, that guy's weapon to the next one, that guy's weapon to the next one, just like Mega Man. I don't see any difference.
Zach?
I haven't played the game.
I know you haven't, and that's why...
I'm trying to get you a slow clap with me.
That's why part of this, the echo chamber of the hate that it's getting, it's not the greatest game ever. I told one guy I'd give it a 7, maybe a 7.5. In some people's mind, that's shit. But it's getting like 5s. And it does not deserve 5s.
I will say, though,
it's crazy. People deserve
to be upset about how ugly it is. It was promised a different art style. They showed it off before, where it did not look as just stupid, and the graphics in that game are just absolutely despicable.
Like the little cutscenes and the story scenes, awful. Yeah. Just garbage trash. Beck himself is pretty stupid. But when you're playing the game, I don't even, like, going through the side-scrolling, I don't even notice. I think, like, because I'm dashing all the time or jumping and climbing, it looks fine. But everything around it, like the non-gameplay parts, is garbage.
Sure.
But
it's looking like checkered walls.
But that's not the gameplay. And to me, this game is about gameplay. And it's the gameplay is fun. So that's why I'm just like, I don't know what people want in games. And they just listen to what other people say. They're just going to hate on shit. And without even, I guarantee most of the people who are doing it didn't even give it a fair shake. Sure. I guarantee it.
What constitutes a fair shake, though? Because if you're having an issue for the first hour, I'd be kind of soured.
Well, that's because I'm used to Mega Man controls in that environment. If you're not used to Mega Man controls in that environment, you can pick it up. Fine. But
clean slate.
A clean slate, you should be okay. Like I said, it's just like kind of like what I was giving Zach a hard time for with Overwatch. His first match, he was like, I'm not able to do this stuff. And I just wanted to be like, it's your first match, dude. Learn the shit first and then get into it.
It
just
was like amplified because of my inebriation.
Oh, absolutely. 100%. I will back that. If it's just like Dark Souls, if I were to pick up Dark Souls, I tried Bloodborne for 4 hours and I could not get the control, so I quit.
Yeah.
It's a fair shake to how long am I progressing? I went like 4 hours and my control did not progress at all. However, with Mighty No. 9, I was getting progression in that first hour. It just wasn't clicking as fast as I wanted it to. But then, like I said, I quit and I came back and it just started coming.
Yeah.
And 4 hours and you couldn't get Bloodborne controls?
No, Bloodborne controls are just garbage to me. I can't figure it out.
That's crazy. They're tight.
I mean, I don't think they were that bad. Like, not bad at all. I don't think they were that hard to learn, per se. It's hard. It's a hard game. Targeting was weird. I don't know. But
people say, like I said, the same thing in Mega Man. Well, they say it's hard and the platforming is tough. And I'm like, that shit's easy.
Well, want to know the good thing about this, Jace?
What's up?
When you like Mighty No. 9, you can keep playing it. For everybody who doesn't like it, they can fuck off and not play it anymore. Because the game already exists.
Yeah.
But there it is.
But the shitty thing of it is these people are shitting on it without, and the people who may play it and enjoy it aren't going to play it just because. And who knows what that means for its future. I would like a second one.
Sure.
I feel like they can take it and they can make something really cool with the second one. But
how much is it?
It's 20 if you buy it digital, I believe.
20.
Yeah. Because it's like 30 in store. And then they have, it's something I wish people would give a fair shake, like in the short version of it, but I'm going to keep fucking playing it though. I'm going to play all the hard levels and I'm going to keep playing it cause I like it.
Good. Do you have more games that have made list?
That's it.
Can I go over some games that were released and
the witness in there?
The Witness was the first half of the year.
Witness was in January.
Yeah.
Oh, that was just the... Okay. So by list, you meant just the second part.
Yes. Like I said... I kind of wanted... like I said, when I alluded to the...
The best
running,
one.
The running top 10 type thing, but I didn't make one, so...
I just want to go through and list some stuff that have come out in the second half of the year. And some of them definitely deserve to have a shout out given to them, even though I know none of us played them.
The last time I went through that whole list, and I know there's a lot of it that's just irrelevant to us, so I kind of just cherry picked. Yeah. And I was like, they'll fill in the rest. So
now this we might have actually talked about this game the first quarter, because depending on when that show was, I don't remember, but we talked about it some, and it was Quantum Break. And that came out April 5th. So that was like the first big game to come out in the second quarter.
Yeah, that just came out right before
we did our show. Other
show. And because that one and Dark Souls, they both came out. And we like, neither of them qualify for this.
Okay.
So we didn't really talk about it, I don't think.
Okay, cool. Yeah, because Dark Souls was right after that on April 12th. So it was only a week separated from the two games. And Ratchet & Clank was that exact same day, April 12th. So that those two came out on the same day.
Yeah.
Those are really the only ones in April that mattered to me. Now, it's when you get to May that there's a ton of games that came out. This month had so many games. The first one that came out is a little sad. Battleborn. It's the one that just got shat upon by every other game surrounding it. Everybody
it's just because of the beta. We all knew what it was. It wasn't even like it didn't have a fair shake.
So that game, it just came and went. It came out on May 3rd, 21 days before Overwatch came out. And obviously everybody saved their money and just got Overwatch. The problem is I believe the Overwatch beta was taking place like right on or around when Battleborn came out. So Battleborn already had a beta. Then everybody just waited for the Overwatch beta to see which one was better. And then the Overwatch beta happened, and everybody's like, well, fuck Battleborn. We're all waiting for Overwatch.
And Battleborn's a MOBA.
Battleborn is a straight-up MOBA.
Battleborn's a MOBA. I'll give you that one. So the question is, which one had the first release date? Do we know, like, which company decided to, like,
I don't know.
All right, because
I would have Overwatch to have done real research first, to figure that out.
Battleborn's like, oh, we'll just do it around the same time. Then they fucked up.
Yep. I would have needed to do real research to know that, and I didn't do that, so I'm sorry.
I don't know any publisher that would want to go toe to toe with Blizzard with like a similar game.
Mm-mm. No.
Yeah.
Oh no.
So another game that came and went, didn't get talked about much, but went through development hell was Homefront: The Revolution. No, this one didn't come out.
Oh shit! Yeah.
This one actually didn't go through development hell. The first one did, I think. But this one was just made, and nobody liked it, and it sucks, I guess.
Was it this one that had, like, an apology note from the guy?
Oh, I don't think so.
I'm going to look it up. I'm pretty sure.
Maybe. Either way, Homefront: The Revolution came out, and I guess it's just terrible. I want to give a... And then also on May 17th is Valkyria Chronicles Remastered, which was a game that I got and platinumed in a week.
I was writing that one, and I marked it out. I was like, he'll check me on that one.
Yep. So I have to throw that out there. Some more games that came out. The Ninja Turtles, Mutants in Manhattan, which was supposedly really bad, which is unfortunate because we wanted a good Ninja Turtles game. And it's just yet another game that proves that Platinum Games is going down the shithole.
Going down. Those guys have been in the shithole for a while now.
Yeah. And then,
in my opinion.
Yep.
IMO.
May 30th.
Real quick.
Yo.
There is, it's not really much an apology, but like the ending credits for Homefront 2 includes a note from the director acknowledging its troubled development.
Oh, hey.
Which,
that's because the studio that was making the game got shut down right in the middle of development, and then had to get sold to somebody else, and they worked on it, and then they also contracted out half the work. So it had a crazy thing happen because the studio shut down mid development.
Super crazy.
Yeah, super crazy.
Fun note: Mighty Number 9's credits are apparently 4 hours long.
Yeah,
They list every backer.
Like all 30,000 or like 25,000 or something.
And they put a little feature in there where you can scroll and look for there's a 5-digit number at the top, and you can scroll and you can make a number, and you're assigned a mighty number for your backer number, and you can highlight or find your name in the credits.
Yep.
Which I was like, oh, that's cool, because it popped up and I was like, what is this? And I was putting in random numbers. I was just like, I don't know what this is. And I looked it up. I was like, that makes sense.
It's kind of
neat. Apparently it's 4 hours long.
Can you imagine the credits on Star Citizen? That's gonna be insane.
No.
Just throwing it out there.
No, I don't want to think about that.
Oh, you will?
I'm thinking about it now. Maybe that wasn't part of the agreement, though, because the problem with Mighty Number 9 is you got in the credits at $5. So anyone who gave them at least $5 got their name in the credits.
There were so many that were just, A generous backer.
Because there's a couple thousand of them that they didn't even give names. So it's just a generous backer. They can't just skip. They can't just be like, oh, well, number 1,000 through number 2,400 are just generous backer. They can't just
do that. Because number 43 is a real person.
So. Yeah, so
Man, they must be scrolling really slow for that to be 4 hours.
Jesus. There's just that.
Well, it's like 20,000 backers or something.
More than that. It's more than that. It's like 25. Anyway, Oxenfree came out on May 31st. Both me and
Tim
have played that. Interesting game. We've talked about it at length already on the show.
That came out in January on PC.
Yeah.
I'm not super excited to do it again because...
Me either.
I'll run in that game, right? I was having the hardest time. Like, I'd have my person go up the hill and they just kind of be like...
I think
you can. Holy fuck.
Are you sure? I think you can run.
I was smashing buttons. I was trying. I'm pissed.
If you played the whole through the whole thing and there was a run button, that's hilarious.
You unlock the run button.
Anyway,
Game Plus.
Smite officially released on PS4 on May 31st.
Smote him.
It was technically in beta forever, but it officially released on May 31st, which is funny because that's approximately the time where all of us stopped playing the game because we've not been smiting.
I haven't smote in a long time.
Smoting and smiting. I think I stopped when I started playing Overwatch.
Yeah. So we've not been doing that. Anyway, this last month has still had some other games worth talking about. Mirror's Edge 2 Catalyst in there, which is yet another game that is everybody considering quite a failure. Everybody begged and pleaded for this game, and then nobody bought it, and nobody likes it either. So great.
How many people are begging, though, like, throughout the years?
A very vocal minority, a vocal group, very vocal people, but a minority nonetheless. So that's unfortunate. And then the Resident Evil game, that Umbrella Corps game, came out, and nobody even knew that it came out. It's a multiplayer shooting Resident Evil game that literally just came out the same day as Mighty No. 9, June 21. Nobody even knew this game existed. Both of you guys don't even know what I'm talking about.
I just saw it on the Steam Summer Sale.
Is it like Operation Raccoon City?
No, it's like a multiplayer shoot 'em up,
like
co-op thing. Like a real, but it's a Resident Evil. It's called Resident Evil Umbrella Corps.
Umbrella Corps Biohazard.
Shoot 'em up. Like what?
It means like it's like it's a co-op horde type game where you're gonna kill a shit ton of zombies. It's not a horror game. It's like a shooter. But
it looks like Left
4
Dead.
It's like squad based. Yeah, think Left 4 Dead or Dead Island when you have a team.
Left 4 Dead.
So it's like Operation Raccoon City.
I don't know what that. I guess I don't know what that one is. Maybe.
Rack City, bitch.
It came out in like 2008 or 9, and it's like a story based third person shooting, and you can have like four people multiplayer.
Yeah, that sounds very similar.
Ooh, mostly negative reviews.
Yeah.
26% of the 575 are positive.
Yeah. And there is still one game that I want to throw out there, only because it technically will come out in the second quarter, and I will probably play it because there's nothing that comes out in July. That's Star Ocean 5. I love the Star Ocean series. I think they're really interesting. This one looks good. I always have high hopes for Star Ocean because it's a cool series.
I hope.
And so, considering there's not a single game in July coming out that I will buy or even care about in any way, except for I Am Setsuna, which is an RPG, I will be playing that one. It's like an old-school RPG. It has a lot of Chrono Trigger.
Is that that? No.
Oh.
I don't know.
People should look up I Am Setsuna. It's going to be a sweet-ass RPG
that comes out.
Yep, it comes out July 12th for PlayStation Plus members. And probably at a discount, so you should pick it up the day when it comes out.
Setsuna, S-E-T.
S-E-T-S-U-N-A. I am Setsuna.
I put Satsuna.
Yeah.
Well,
it looks pretty cool. The art style is pretty sweet.
Yep. I think that game will be neat, nice. So I might actually go and check out Star Ocean, though, because a huge-ass RPG, I kind of don't have anything I'm playing at the moment. No, it's going to be big. Star Ocean is like 100 hours minimum, probably. So
holy motherfuck, dude.
It's going to be a long game. If I invest in
this
game...
Did I say huge ass? I meant huge ass.
It's at least... Yeah.
I don't mind 100-hour RPGs, but sometimes they feel like...
I'm over that stuff.
Well, it's just like very few, like, they don't hold you the entire time. You have to like push through. There's like a couple parts where it's like, fuck.
Yeah.
If that 100 hours was 100 hours of good time, okay. But these games that are way too fucking long because there's so much filler in there that doesn't need to be in there.
Yeah. It's 60 hours of fetch quests, of side games, of grinding, of you know, all this other shit that you just have to do in the game.
Crafting. Excited, man. That
I just want
20
hour
good.
Games. That's all I want. I want 20 hours.
Well, I haven't decided if I'm gonna invest in it, but it's still great. The JRPG revolution is happening, and Star Ocean. Star Ocean is a great it's a great one coming out. A lot of people really love this series. Like, this series has been around a long fucking time. Like, over there, I have the PS2 one, which is the first one that came out. Or PS1 that came out. It's PS1 the first one. It's the first one that came to America. It's the first Star Ocean game that came to America.
Oh.
Hold on. I'll find it, because I'll just do that.
Hold on, everybody.
Hold on.
This is the same crowd that wanted Mirror's Edge 2.
This is Star Ocean Second Story. It's funny because Second Story
is the first one.
Is the first one that came to America. The first actual Star Ocean game only came out in Japan. This is the first one we got. The series has been around for a long fucking time. There's a ton of these games.
I rented 2. And I was like, I didn't play very much of it.
Meh.
They're fun. They're really fun. But you have to be ready to invest in them.
Invest.
I can't do it, man.
That's what they say.
Yeah, I think that has to do. That's it for video games.
I think that's it. Like I said, pretty good quarter. I think definitely better than the first quarter of 2016. And I think it's only going to keep going up.
Oh, yeah. I think that
for the rest of the year, maybe.
I just closed my page.
Let's hope so. Cool. Let's hope so.
I don't know. We'll be back on this
Final
topic.
Fantasy 15, down No Man's Sky, Battlefield 1, yep. Titanfall 2.
Just Final Fantasy 15 is just enough in and of itself.
Mankind
War,
Divided.
Maybe.
South Park Fractured Butthole.
Hey, has that been confirmed?
What?
The God of War. Is that coming out in 2017?
No, it doesn't have it yet.
Yeah, I hope we see it 2017. It'll probably be holiday 2017.
I bet it'll be spring 18.
Yeah, I can see that too. But we get South Park Fractured Butthole later this year. That makes me excited.
Oh, yeah.
No, but yeah, we have plenty. But yeah, that's the year in review, 2016 halfway through.
Yeah.
Good job, Chase.
So that was video games. Do you guys want to talk anything else the second half? Like, has there been any movies that you care about?
Nope, no movies this year.
Rolling right on to movies there, Zach. Rolling right into it.
Why not? Unless you guys want to name your favorite your favorite game of the second quarter.
No. Okay, I'll roll right into movies.
Okay, there you go.
Is anyone else excited for the Ultimate Edition Batman vs. Superman?
No.
Just for the simple fact that it's supposed to be like a different movie.
It's rated R is cool. I like that. But it also, it's going to make it more convoluted because they're adding more characters that they cut.
It's not so much that. They're just putting...
Maybe it will piece it all together.
Add shit. Yeah. It's just like, I don't know where the R rated comes in. I just think that...
There'll be one gunshot, or maybe they'll say shit twice or something.
Because Batman was straight up killing fools in that movie, so I don't really know.
He was.
He was just murdering them.
Absolute maybe there'll murder. Be more blood. Was there blood in the first one? Like, a lot of it?
I'm
going to take that as a not...
No. Not that,
did you not
that
see it?
Not noticeable amount. What?
Did you not see it?
Fuck no.
Jace doesn't see movies.
It's like, well, it's on demand or something. I'll watch that. I've not been... See, the reason I said no so sternly, I've not been excited for this one bit. Technically, that's not true. Once I said Ben Affleck was the Batman, I got a little bit excited, but I was like, I don't like the Superman. I don't like what they're doing with Superman. The first Man of Steel was one of the worst movies I've ever seen in my life.
I like that movie a lot.
Just the idea that they're going to be like, here's all these people and all this shit. And then I watched the trailer and I was like, they've already gave away like Doomsday and just all this shit in there.
The
trailer was bad. I was just like, this just doesn't interest me at all. I'm like, I'll watch Ben Affleck Batman movies, but I'll wait for the like on demand to watch this Batman v Superman.
I will throw it out there. I know we've already talked about it, but I'm a huge Batman fan. That's why I want to see the movie, and he's the only reason you'd want to watch the movie.
That's what I hear, and it makes
Superman
me excited.
Superman was terrible. Wonder Woman was kind of cool, but Doomsday
was
terrible.
Only in there for like two scenes, yeah.
Yeah, Lex Luthor is terrible.
And they show Wonder Woman and Superman do not have a single spoken word with each other.
In the trailer, yeah, they showed Wonder Woman in two scenes. And I hear she's in there for two scenes.
Yeah.
Like, well, that's...
And she's in the dinner. But, yeah, she's not a main character. But Batman, Ben Affleck did a good job.
Ben Affleck. We'll move on. We had a whole episode about Batman vs. Superman that we did.
Sure did. You sure did. It was an offshoot. I wasn't there.
Yeah.
Hey, you said bring up movies, Zach, so I'm just trying to throw shit out there.
I think that was the first half of the year. I mean, the first quarter. First quarter.
No, that was in March.
Yeah, that's the first quarter.
Oh, March, sorry. Baby. I misunderstood.
Damn it, Jace. Yeah,
I'm sorry. I know!
Honestly, I don't want to talk a lot about movies because movies suck nowadays.
They're pretty bad.
I hate most movies anymore. I know that is a terrible thing to say, but especially since I graduated with a film degree.
I graduated with business degrees and I had business.
So. Guys, Let me tell you about the film, guys. I need a pen.
Anyway, in April, there's not really a whole lot that came out that I think mattered, but the Ratchet and Clank movie came out, which is really sad because it had the opposite reception that the video game had. Everybody hated the movie. It's supposedly really, really bad. It did not make any money. It bombed. Straight up bombed.
Which
I also didn't see any advertising for it, though. It doesn't make it a better movie.
They didn't have any advertising for it at all, but I guess the movie lost all of the heart that what the games have because it didn't have any of the cool guns. It didn't have... What? Like, it couldn't have any of the explosions and the gadgets. Fun. Like, he only uses, like, the pistol or something like that. He doesn't use gadgets very much. He doesn't use any of the neat guns. It's really dull and, I guess, like, just uneventful.
I don't know how that happens because the game itself kind of plays out like a kid's movie. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of got that basic story.
Well, and there are scenes in the game that are from the movie. Like, whenever it cuts to the scene and then it says in the top left, it says it's blocking gameplay because or whatever. Like, it's blocking you from streaming gameplay. It'll say that on everybody's screen. But it does that because that's actually a clip from the movie that they've just used in the game. And that's why It looks just a little different.
Wow. Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah. They're actually using clips from the movie in the game. And I guess, though, that... I mean, because when you go back and you watch those clips, it's like, man, all those clips are fucking boring. And it's probably the worst part about the game is the clips actually coming from the film.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. I didn't know.
So you would say gameplay over story makes Ratchet a good game?
Well, the thing is there's not very many of these occurrences. It only happens a few times. And most of the story is told, and it does not happen during those few scenes that are pulled from the movie.
And to be fair, like, the story in the reboot, it really wasn't that great. It was more like a nostalgia game.
Yeah. So you would say it's a good game because of the gameplay more than the story?
Mixed with the nostalgia factor, which is huge.
Yeah.
I have nostalgia for Ratchet and Clank. I never played them.
I did.
I played them when I first came out. It was great.
Yeah. The next big movie that I cared about came out May 6th, and that was Captain America Civil War, which hoping to do a review on. We never had time to do it, though, which is unfortunate. I loved that movie. I don't even think it's close to the best Marvel movie, though. I still
what
like
is?
Guardians of the Galaxy by a lot.
I think Days of Future Past was the best.
That's a Fox movie.
Oh, what?
That's a movie made by Fox. The X-Men movies and the Marvel movies, that's why they don't cross over.
Oh, fuck, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so, like...
Oh, I thought you were talking about my favorite superhero movie.
No, I just meant, like, Marvel. Like, it's not even close to the best Marvel movie.
Okay.
But it was still good.
Jace, you're shaking your head. We know Green Lantern's your favorite movie. Fuck.
DC for life.
Green Lantern, Ryan Reynolds is making a comeback.
Okay. So you just refuse to watch Marvel movies?
Marvel movies. I think Jace actually saw this one.
I did. I've seen all of them but Ant-Man.
Ant-Man's great.
No, I hear it's good. I want to watch it. I just, I've stopped buying movies, and I don't rent movies. So until it's on demand in front of my face, I, like, don't watch.
You could definitely go find it on Redbox.
Redbox, yeah.
Going to a Redbox, getting a thing from them that I have to take back within a day.
Go and buy yourself
That's just
a soda
a
pop.
Hassle and a half.
Go get yourself a soda pop.
A soda pop?
From the Walgreens.
Go get some more peaches.
From the Walgreens. Get your can of peaches and get your red box. And have a gay old night. And then the next night, take your red box back. Get a second can of peaches.
Go on.
But make sure you get a different soda. So because the variety is the spice of life.
So I'm getting these cans of peaches at my Redbox.
At your Walgreens, your local Walgreens, which normally accompanies has a Redbox accompanying them.
Jace, you know I was telling you that you're a homeless man for just eating peaches for dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Canned peaches. Now that I'm seeing the beard, it's like even more true.
Oh, it's awesome.
Hey, keeping us on track, did you guys see X-Men Apocalypse?
No.
No.
Okay. It was okay.
Just okay.
I didn't even watch any of the X-Mans until December. And I watched all 7 of them. And I was like, eh.
I think I'd say it too if I watched all 7.
I think X-Men 2 is probably my favorite of all of the X-Men movies. X2. Time Wolverine straight up murders somebody in the X-Mansion. And I'm just like, I was like, holy shit. Wolverine is murdering people in this movie. And this is awesome.
He murders a shit ton of people in Apocalypse. You actually get to see him in his Weapon X little headset.
Really?
Thing, yeah.
Weird.
It was kind of retarded.
Great. I mean, like, I've just seen the previews for that movie. I was pretty sure I was going to hate it. So that's unfortunate. Looking into this month, we have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows, which came out June 3rd. I did not see that either. But Bebop and Rocksteady are in it. That's neato.
I hear they're pretty entertaining as well.
Yeah, I heard it's actually a fun movie and nobody should shit on it. Like,
yeah.
Of course it has a terrible rating. Yes, it has a terrible rating.
It's made for its audience. Yeah. Like,
did the first reboot get shit on?
Yeah.
Yeah, big time.
Yeah. Oh, man, that one was great. I liked that a lot.
Because I thought the Turtles were done really well in the first
movie. No!
Well, their personalities, they look stupid, but they were hilarious.
The personalities have been established since 1987, whenever they were made.
Yeah, but
look stupid as fuck.
But even their bad jokes worked. Like, their jokes of, like, where they start, like, making music in the elevator,
again,
which is, like, dumb.
That's part of their personalities that have been made and established.
They're just big old turtles.
No, they look stupid. They look
Why are they wearing so many accessories
to make them individual?
Clearly it's Donatello because he has his goggles and his glasses and whatever. And Raph has his do-rag and his chain and his what? The colors. Just have them have different fucking colors. Mikey has, I don't know. I hate the fact that they have all this extra shit on them, just so you know that they're different.
Yeah,
they were
trying to give them like ways of standing out and being individuals.
And that should be their personality. Like, who fucking cares what they're
wearing? Yeah, you're right. But they also gotta show how many fucking things they can put on a fake ass turtle in computers. They want to prove how cool they can be.
Fucking hate computers.
So, you know. Anyway, there is a couple more. The Warcraft movie came out on June 10th.
Saw that. Did you guys see
it? Like
that?
I said, I
want to see it. I have convinced my wife to go see it with me, but we have not found the time to actually go see it.
Let me tell you what I think. No spoilers, though. I thought it was a pretty good movie for what it was. I never played World of Warcraft, but I did play like Warcraft games, like Warcraft and Warcraft 2, Warcraft 3, that kind of stuff. The orcs were the best part of the movie. I thought they were awesome, had like their own personality. I thought the humans were terrible.
Oh, no.
You might think it different, but...
I bet the humans look bad in CGI.
It's not that. It was just like... It was supposed to like be like this big group of humans, and then it would only ever show like five on screen. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's because you can't get too many people standing in front of a green screen.
Yes, yeah, it's hard to properly light them all so that you can green screen it well.
Well, you need to watch it, Zach, so we can talk about it. So I think Nina liked it.
I will actually go see it. I've been meaning to go see it, but I haven't been able to find the time. So, and that's on June 17, it just came out. We had Finding Dory. The second one in the Finding Nemo series. I like Finding Nemo enough, I guess.
Not doing it.
Pixar.
I don't even know if I've seen the first one all the way through.
Really? It's fine.
I don't like Ellen DeGeneres. Her voice irritates me.
Well, you're definitely going to hate this movie then.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Because that's what you're going to get for
90 minutes.
Yeah, 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 yeah. But there are some movies, though, that I have to look forward to coming out. I'm going to list just a few. The new Ghostbusters reboot, I'm interested to see the reaction.
I'm going to wait.
Are you interested in the movie, though?
Yeah, the new Ghostbusters reboot comes out on July 15th.
No. Okay. Are you actually interested in seeing the movie?
No, I'm interested in seeing the reaction.
Okay, thanks. Got the answer there. I was wondering if...
That's what I said. I was being specific the first time. I wasn't trying to hide my true feelings. I'm not going to see it.
What's another one? I'm waiting for you to name the movie I want you to name.
Star Trek Beyond, R.I.P. Chekhov.
No, but I will go watch that one. I love the first two. They're so good.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Chekhov. He's dead.
He is. I'm really sorry.
You see how he died?
R.I.P. Anton Yelchin.
Makes no fucking sense.
Yeah. Sucks.
Found his body between a car and a mailbox. What the fuck?
Yeah, well, they already figured out what happened, and it's what's really bad about it. It was his Jeep Cherokee, and there's a recall because the transmission in it's confusing. So you think you're putting it in park, and it slips into neutral. So what happened is he came home from something, parked his Jeep, it fell into neutral, and he had walked down to get his mail. His car went and slipped into
Holy
neutral,
shit.
Rolled into him, and smashed him against his stone mailbox and killed him.
Holy shit.
Yeah, so right? It's actually straight up a Jeep recall killed Anton Yelchin.
That's crazy.
Yeah. It's also been associated with more than 40 other injuries so far this year.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, I know, right?
Yikes! Right. Okay, what? Any other more movies? More movies?
Suicide Squad.
Oh God!
Comes out later.
You know, I'd be so much more excited for that if Will Smith wasn't in it. I don't know if that's fair, I just don't like that guy at all.
Yeah. It either already came out or it comes out soon. Independence Day 2.
It already came out.
Yeah, that movie's totally sucked.
Raving reviews.
Yeah, people love that movie. There's a Ben-Hur reboot coming out later this year.
Really?
They're doing a remake of Ben-Hur. Can you believe that, Carnage?
Sweet.
I don't know. I'm looking through this list of movies. Okay. There's
Ben-Hur, baby.
The new Harry Potter movie. I think that comes out.
Already?
It comes out
beasts
later this year.
And where to find Incredible... What is it? Incredible Beasts and where to find
Incredible,
them?
Fantastic Beasts and where to
Fantastic.
Find them.
Fantastic.
It comes
Fantastical
out in
beasts.
It comes out in November.
And feasts.
Assassin's feasts? Creed movie comes out in December.
Fantastical Feasts?
Fantastical
Assassin's Feasts? Creed movie. You know what? The second they showed that stupid little contraption that he hooks up into in real life.
Yeah, that's going to suck.
I was like, fuck. I can't do
and
it.
They've also
they showed
announced,
the Animus and you got mad at it?
Yeah.
It's
they've
not
al-
the
they've
animus,
also said
you know
that
talking
like
about.
Set more than 70% of the movie takes place in the real world. Only like 30% takes place in the Animus.
What?
Yeah, they said like an overwhelming amount of the movie takes place in the real world. Anyway,
so
the last but not least, Star Wars Rogue One.
Sausage Party.
Yeah.
What?
Look it up, Sausage Party, for real.
Sausage Party. No. The movie
so
Sausage
good.
Party, the animated
it's gonna
movie
be so
Sausage
good.
Party. It looks
so
fucking
good.
It looks awesome. With Seth Rogen.
Yeah. Yeah, Seth Rogen wrote it. So.
We've been How chosen high was together. He decided
to write that movie. Fuck.
That's gonna be so good.
They're eating children.
You just know that it's gonna at one point that hot dog is gonna go into that bun very,
very slowly. Sexually. Sex music. And they're gonna probably use like ketchup or mayonnaise or mustard as like a lubricant.
It's gonna be a lubricant.
that's pretty much like the top of my movie list. So
that one right there? God, you're a weird guy. You won't go see movies, but I'm gonna go see Sausage Party.
I went and watched Pop Stars.
Was that any good?
It's not really that good of a movie. Like I said,
compared to Hot Rod.
It's not as good as Hot Rod. It doesn't touch Hot Rod.
No, he told me that before, and that made me so sad.
Like I said, if you're not a fan of Lonely Island going in, you will absolutely hate the movie. Okay. But if you like Lonely Island, you can get through it. The other actor cameos are pretty fucking awesome. I felt like it hurt. Like the soundtrack itself is basically their new CD that came out, and I felt like at first it hurt it. But so much time has went by to where kind of the movie is like out of my head when I listen to it, that it is funny and it is worth a listen. But it's just not as good as their other three.
Sure. Mm.
But yeah, it's okay. Definitely listen to the soundtrack if you're a Lonely Island fan.
Okay.
All
right. Well, can you guys think of anything else?
Nope.
Awesome.
Did you say the new Bourne Identity movie? Or Bourne? Is that coming out?
I don't know.
It looks terrible.
Don't know. This is the one with the return of Matt Damon, right?
Yeah, where he's like 80 years old and he's like doing bare knuckle boxing on the beach.
Yeah.
It's like, we get it. You're still a badass there. Jason Bourne, here he comes. He looks 80. I know he's not 80, Zach. Goddamn. He's not 80.
He's not
80. Well, we can either go on and do the other topic. It kind of is up to you guys. Do you guys want to move on and do another topic, or do you guys want to wrap up? Because we have a choice. We have a choice to make right now.
We're out of time.
Fair enough. Well, I guess what we're going to do
is... That was a hell of a half year in review.
Yeah, it really was. And that's fine. What we'll do is we're going to skip over my topic, which is a topic submitted by our viewer. And that's okay.
Wrecked.
That'll hold.
We'll put it on hold and we'll come back to it. It's not like it'll go away. We'll just use it next week.
That is a universal topic.
Yeah, it is. And what we'll do is I wanted to go to Tim's topic because I want to hear him update us on his retro gaming. And then in a way, me and Jace can talk about what we've been playing because we completely skipped over that at the beginning of the show.
And I already did the big portion of mine.
Yeah.
I already went with my spiel.
And I've been playing Overwatch. Like, that pretty much sums up what I've been playing, so.
Destiny, Overwatch, Mighty No. 9, and totally spacing on same. Zero Escape, Last Virtue on the Vita.
And my only other game I was playing was South Park, Stick of Truth, which I'm very close to getting the Platinum Trophy on the PS4. So there you go. That wraps up what I've played. Tim, I want to hear about your shit.
Tim.
Wow, that's the quickest I've ever heard you guys go through your games played.
Well, I talked about
beep, beep, boom, boom, boom.
I talked about all four of those before, and I talked about Mighty No. 9 already. Yeah, so.
And people don't need to hear about my shit.
Yeah, no one wants to hear about Mighty No. 9. Okay, so the games I've been playing from you guys' list, it's kind of bad timing because I started a new job, so I'm kind of focused on it. I know, it had to happen. But I've been playing Chrono Trigger and... Yeah. The Legend of Zelda. Those are the two. So Chrono Trigger, I'm not super far. I got to that little island, kind of like at the end of time with the old man by the street lamp.
The first time?
Gives you like, the first time, so you've got like the three different times available to you.
Uh-huh.
I went to like the 10,000 or 10 billion BC time.
Damn.
With all dinosaurs. Got my ass handed to me. I was like, what the hell is going on? It's
not where you should go yet.
Yeah, which is kind of why I moved on to Zelda, because I was frustrated, because it's like, I kind of didn't really know where I was supposed to go at that point. I was like, okay, so I dinked around there for probably longer than I should have, and then I went forward in time, or not forward, where did I go? I think it was like to present time.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm at right now. And then for Zelda, I've got two of the amulets, and I'm going for the third, which is like on the Moon Mountain or whatever at the top of the
Moon Mountain.
What's it called?
I don't know, but it's not Pokemon.
That's a Pokemon term.
Pokemon is Mount Moon.
But yeah. Mount Moon. Okay, so it's like it's at the top of that mountain where you can go to a magical location, realm though. And you turn into a pink rabbit. What the fuck?
Oh yeah. Yeah,
that one threw me.
That happens.
I'm like, what the hell's going on? And I'm kind of walking around, look like the Easter Bunny. So I'm in that dungeon right now.
Okay.
And then I've poked at other games. I played Mega Man 2. I beat Bubble Man. And I didn't know that you're supposed to like do the bosses. They're supposed to like set you up to like beat another one. I went straight on to the Air Man, whatever his name is.
Airman.
That level just is wrecking me.
Yeah, you're not ready for that yet.
Okay, so, and then I've played a little bit of Kirby. That's a lot of fun. I've Mario World, I'm slowly going through that. I've played that a little before, so that's a shit ton of fun. But that's about it. My PlayStation emulator is not working, so I have to fix that because I really wanted to try Tomba out.
Oh, yeah.
Tomba!
Yeah, kind of nice. Stoked on that one.
Yeah.
But that's pretty much it for my update right now. Mostly Zelda.
So, just for one quick thing about Chrono Trigger, the game is confusing. It actually is specifically confusing because of the time skips and shit. You jump all around time, you do stuff here, then you have to go to another time because you're always changing it. I don't recommend you use a walkthrough. Do not use a walkthrough of telling you everything exactly how to go through every space. But you should use a guide kind of telling you, hey, just so you know, when they throw you out of here into nowhere and you just wander, this is the direction you need to go. Go to this time period at least. Like, use a general guide to at least get you to the on the right track, because you can wander that game endlessly for hours not knowing where to go, and there's like one specific fucking thing you have to go do.
Which is why I've never played through the whole game, is because I do this toward the beginning and I wander off and I'm like, where do I go every time?
Yeah,
I just
and it's great, Tim, that you've even gotten to the point where you are.
But I feel like it's been pretty linear up to this point.
Yeah,
like,
and
got here pretty easily.
So there are certain times in the game where it does feel like that, where you have long sections where you can't deviate, but then they throw you into this one section where it's like, okay, we're going to have it be open-ended, and we're not going to tell you exactly what to do, and you got to go figure it out. And it's those little breaks that can make this game infuriating, because they don't tell you exactly what to do, and you have to go find it. And it's those little sections that will drive you nuts. But then it will be followed with a long portion of it being linear. Does that
make sense?
Are
you telling me I shouldn't be in the 10 billion BC world?
Not even freaking close. I do believe you're supposed to go back to 600 AD.
Okay.
I'll look up the guide.
That's a good idea.
I can't remember exactly. I know, if you went to the end of time for the first time, I believe the first thing you're supposed to do is make sure you've gotten all of your magic for your characters while you're there, and you fought the guy and he gave you magic.
I did that.
And then I believe you're supposed to go back to 600 AD. But I'm not 100% positive. It's been a while since I played the game. But definitely not 10 million BC. It's not the right place to go.
Okay, thank God. Hey, so when I can only have like the party of three, and I have to leave some poor sap at the lamp with the creepy old guy.
Oh, yes, you do. Yeah.
When I'm leveling up with my group, will he level up too?
Yes, but at a slightly slower rate. So they'll still get levels, but they won't get them as quickly.
See, this is what fucked me in Final Fantasy IX, because you know that part in the game where you have to like pick four characters to go in the castle, and then it's like, oh, by the way, play the other four characters while they go a separate way. And I put my best team over here, and all of a sudden I'm playing the four characters which I didn't spend any time leveling up.
And you're just stuck, getting demolished.
Completely stuck, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, this is one of those games where you can actually end up playing through that entire game for the most part with just the characters you want. But when you end up having to do missions, there's always going to be storylines based on every character so that you can learn about them. So you're going to be forced to use every character in that game at certain points.
Okay.
So no matter what, you've got to level them at certain points.
Because it's like, I'm the kind of guy...
Chrono Trigger is not the game that you're ever going to have to feel that you need to go out of your way to grind a lot for. It's not that game, in my opinion.
Good.
Like, you're never going to have to go super far out of your way to grind.
All right. Just a little out of my way?
Only sometimes when you have to get enough money so you can buy the good enough equipment. Like, there's always times, and that's
money.
That's every RPG you will play forever and ever. It will never change. There's going to be times you have to grind out gold so that you can buy the new equipment. It's like an RPG staple.
Grind that gold.
Hey, speaking of RPGs, I can't remember. Do we know if Persona 5 is coming out this year in the U.S.?
No, nope.
It's February.
February, next
February.
Year.
February, okay.
Disappointing.
You gonna watch streams of it, like earlier than that? I'm assuming that some people.
No, I will not watch any of the Japanese stuff just because I'll have no idea what's going on. I won't care. I mean, it'll be nice.
Yes, you will.
You can see the battle system and stuff, but maybe I'll watch a gameplay video, like a YouTube video for like 2 minutes to see how the battles work. But other than that, I won't watch like any extended play.
Story, yeah.
Yeah, because it just is pointless.
And
those games are about the story, so why would you want any of it spoiled?
No, it is about the story, but it's going to be in Japanese. So it won't matter.
I know, but even if you go, especially if you go to watch a stream or something, and people, you know, chat. Chats are crazy.
Yeah, that's true.
Chats be cray?
Well, and somehow they're going to actually know the story, so. Yeah, it's about that time to wrap up the show.
People speak Japanese. You do know this, right?
Yeah, lots of people speak Japanese.
Let's count down here, Jace. Let's see how long it takes Zach to wrap up here.
Oh, I thought we were going to count down how many people speak Japanese. I thought that would have been a really fun.
Where would we start?
We start
a lot less than a lot, even less than that, even less than that.
Countdown.
Well, when I say countdown, we got to start at all of them, and then you do
That's
minus numbers.
All of them. Yeah. Not as many as that. Less than that. Yeah. Less than that.
Yeah.
Also, Game of Thrones season's of finale is starting right now.
Oh shit!
Right now. It is. I'm not going to watch it until 9 o'clock when it's available.
I'm watching it right now.
Is it like an hour and a half or something like that?
It should only be an hour. They're always.
I think it's a little longer than that there, buddy.
I feel like the episodes, as the season's been progressing, have been getting longer and longer.
Okay. Well, I'm super pumped for Game of Thrones, too. So, yes, we'll wrap this up. This has been an awesome episode. Thank you guys for joining. This has been HutchCast Live, episode 20. I'm your host, Zach Hutchins, a.k.a. The Gaming Hutch. Joining me this week was Jace Baldridge.
Hey.
And Timothy Hayes.
Him.
We'll be back next week at 6:30. It will be me and somebody because Jace will not be here. It will not be me. We will not be here next week.
I was going to say, you told me you weren't even...
Yep. I'll be gone at a wedding. Jace is gone doing something else. So we'll not be
I'm
here
going
next
home.
Week. Yeah, Jace is going home.
I thought you are home right now. Isn't that your home?
No, this He's is going my to see his apartment. Parents. This isn't my home. This is my apartment.
There you go. Anyway.
Home is where the heart is.
So the next time time HutchCast Live is back, it'll be the three of us again because it'll be the following week. So we'll see all of you guys in a couple weeks. And with that, we be bouncing.
Bye.
Later.